Hello there everyone, and welcome back to the channel where we are being thrown into the thick of the Eastern Front in Hidden Stroke 2. Oh wow. Well, that supply took some MG42'd. Now, I did record the first half of this mission. It is the Battle of Kursk. Now, in the first half, obviously the Germans overrun our positions with the new armoured vehicles, the Elephant, the Tiger, the Panther. And we've actually received mass reinforcements. For some reason, the enemy thinks it's a good idea to attack that train station. We actually have so many units here. I don't know what I was doing last time I was playing. We've all just been grouped up. There's no way I'm going to be able to organise them properly before the Jerry's show up. We have some bombers probably heading to the train station. Something just blown up over here. Oh dear, what's going on? So we've counter-attacked this hill pretty much and pushed the Germans off it. Probably the only defensive position that held from the initial German attacks, actually. Let's just rush this Panzer IV, make sure they get taken out. Yeah, those planes are all bombed, it's all clear. That tank is down. The hill's pretty much ours. I think there's a German sniper in that foxhole, but our tanks will take care of that for us. I can hear some rear guard action going on over here as well. Oh dear, what's going on? Yeah, the Germans seem to have aligned themselves in this village here. I'm not sure whether they'll attack the station. We do have our armoured train as well. Please move into the station. So anything truck-wise, throw to the back, because otherwise it's just going to get crushed by the German tanks. We have this poor guy here on the Maxim machine gun. The hill seems to be secure. That foxhole won't last forever. This flank also seems secure. So they're all good. I'm not sure what this rear guard action here is. Not a clue what's going on here. They seem to be aligned around this area. I'll try a spy plane, but probably get shot down. Now I'm expecting the Germans from any direction. Really. What's the train doing? Why can't it move? Well, how did it move here, first of all, without... What's it doing? Oh, some of the crew got out of the train or something. Huh. The train's just stuck. That's weird. Yeah. Strange. I guess the train's stuck. Oh dear, look, they're behind us. Oh, what can we see? Oh wow. The second I start observing the German position, you get shot down. Should defend this bunker, to be fair. Another thing that's good about Hidden Stroke is not all officers have binoculars, but then again, it doesn't really feel like Sudden Strike 2 without the binoculars. There are many good and bad points about this version. Some things visually look better, some things don't. The balances are improved in certain ways. In other ways, they are not so good. For example, some buildings are now next to invincible, and you can sit there forever trying to destroy them. But it does introduce a load of new vehicles and models, so. And it fixes most of the bugs from the Hidden Stroke 1 version. Hmm. Oh dear. What's this? Oh man. Oh, we got an ISU now. Okay. I'm not sure whether all of these vehicles are actually realistically appropriate for the Battle of Kursk. The SU-100 I don't think was invented yet. The T-34-85 was late 1943, so there's a slim chance. Man, that guy's got some range. And what's going on over here? National. The National has no armour, so let's just push him. One of our tanks needs a repair, actually. So. Our command post is being attacked. By who? Just bounce back over here. I need to get a repair truck to that tank. Oh wow, he killed our tank. Unbelievable. And he was, the National was also disabled, so. Is this the attack on our command post? Is our reinforcements? We can't really hold people off with just self-propelled guns. The Nashorn is dead. These guys are all down. Right. That gun can't do any damage to the Panzer IV, I think. KV, sorry. What am I talking about? KV-2? The Beast? Man, motorbikes. Oh dear, oh dear. They're probably being flanked on the field or something. Yeah, those Panzerjäger vehicles are so weak. Yeah. Some T-34s down. This army group completely behind the front line should just press towards the station. This infantry. I'll check what's going on over here. We seem to have repulsed some Panzer IVs. The Germans are being shot out from behind the buildings. I'll send out the BA-64s because they're the only vehicles with machine guns. And our army is heading in from behind, so these Germans are trapped. So our objective now is to liberate the entire map from the Germans, which will take some time actually. What's going on over here? Snipers. We held this hill, barely, as well. The snipers are dead. We don't have any Katyusha rockets. This one's decent. Let's retake this farm actually, because it's the lifeblood of their reinforcements heading towards our command post. Oh no, what's the jeep of the officer doing? There's a Ferdinand elephant sitting in that field there, with its back to us. Oh, it didn't even turn around. It's lucky us. Up goes the weasel. I bet you they've deployed some anti-tank guns. There'll be trucks everywhere. Ah, what's that? Yeah, Flak 88. I would say that the Flak is better than our guns, but it's not really the case considering the Soviets invented the BS-43 mod 100mm gun, which is more than adequate enough to take out any German army. Though the Flak does actually have the advantage of being higher above the ground, more elevation, so. Oh, we got the T-34, not T-34. I keep naming things wrong, I don't know what's going on. The T-26 flamethrower tank. Let's just get an operational overview here. What's this? Oh, there's still enemies in that little thing. We must liberate this town first and foremost from the Germans on the right flank. Luckily, luckily there's no fuel mechanics in this, otherwise we would be in trouble. I'll bring most of the army over there. Oh, is it just an ISU driving down the road? Grouping everyone up is such a nightmare. We should definitely just scout around the entire map for any German vehicles just lying around in the fields. Aerial recon would have been best, but we've got these anti-aircraft guns. We have a machine gunner to go in there and just take them down. Do you have a sniper, but he's got no ammunition? Incredible. Are you throwing Molotovs? Oh dear. We've infiltrated behind her. So we'll swing all the way over here and link up with these guys, at least for the assault on the right flank. So this is what I mean by buildings being too overpowered. Like, this house has way too much health, or this foxhole. The guy inside it's got too much protection. Though if we had like an entire Soviet tank army sitting outside, they die very quickly. Yeah, German anti-tank gun pack 40. Take it. What are these guys doing sometimes? We'll head in behind them as well with this infantry. We should unload all this infantry since we're just riding around. Way too openly. Who's this up here as well? Huh. All of our trucks. And see why the Soviets had several generals per front, because if you had one man managing all of this, it becomes very overwhelming very quickly. We'll push them out of this western suburb, and then the guys going round will come out to this plateau, is it? Or steppe, and crush them. They're a very small force, though, supported by two SU-100s, so they ain't really got much power. Perfect, perfect. Oh, there's more foxholes with people in. Oh dear. What's this here? Russian anti-aircraft. Probably not the best place to attack, actually. The infantry took care of that anti-tank gun in the village. Yeah, definitely sitting in one of these bunkers. Flag in position. There's not many German tanks left here. Need to get out from underneath the mortars as well. I wonder how they can see us here. Apparently there's a build. Oh yeah, look, they're sitting in this. I did cheat there, but they're sitting in that hay bale. It's dirty. Trying to use our artillery. One motorway. Where the hell? Where is that coming from? Down there. And there's some like big German gun shooting at us. From somewhere. I can hear it over here. Start surrounding them. There are artillery down there. Anti-tank. They are in a lot of these houses as well, as I've just seen on the map. There's an overpowered gun. Oh, it's our gun? 100 mil. Oh dear. Behind the building, could be. Just spam T-34s everywhere because I can't find the anti-tank guns quick enough. Right, good. Village to the east is secured. Still clearly a few more anti-tank guns that keep killing us. Can actually abandon the Germans here because it's not necessary that we kill them. Took so many losses, but it's fine. I think most of our guys are just sitting outside the village anyway. Just bring everyone over here. I'm just going to use this. I don't like to use the big map because it just ruins the quality of my videos. But the thing is, without it, I'd be back and forth 24/7 on some of these bigger maps. We'll just drag everyone over there. Alright, let's see. We've still got some people in these houses, but it don't matter. Where the hell's that, man? Right. Just kill me. Yeah. This happen? Oh, come on. Kill him, guys. What? How's he got more range than you guys? You're rocking. Unbelievable. Just sent an entire army group there as well, so. We've probably got to be a bit more tactical with what we're doing now, so just spamming units. We have so many, it makes it easier for us to manage them. Right. Got an entire assault brigade there. I think the village has no more people. Oh my goodness. It's an SDK FZ, what's that doing? Yeah. The repair truck strategy from Sunstroke Forever is back. It's a miracle that we can't just shoot these. Yeah, of course. Get off. Got any other units here? No. So these guys are going to take a while to kill. And I don't think I'll be able to find a flamethrower tank anywhere. Tank's still alive. This is why we need flamethrower tanks and stuff, and the KV-2. Right, so now this is going to take a while. Hold on, let me check I'm actually recording all this. Close that. Yeah, okay. We're going to run out of ammunition before we achieve anything with those guys. German though, there's we'll slowly slug those out of the buildings. Then obviously we can capture our old position here. First we should aim for this crossroads, I think. That was the original starting point of our units. The windmills here as well would be good. So we take our old position here. Should have some artillery. Such heavy artillery. And so many vehicles being taken out. Gotta figure out which building they're in actually. They're not in any building here. I don't believe this. What on earth? There's a building over there, but there's no way that should be able to see us. But it can. Alright, let's... regroup. Oh, deal. Let's support the attack. What? What on earth? I'm not very good at hidden stroke. I'm a complete noob, so... our army's just been completely decimated. The jeep's the most annoying unit. It'll just rush itself in. Killed by a gun, which has one man on it. Oh, unbelievable. They have no ammo either. We don't really have many units available here either. Trucks, kind of useless. Let's just take a slower pace. Well, if you're any slower, then their artillery just grinds us down. Reinforcements have arrived, so this should at least strengthen up some of our smaller units. Because we are getting hammered by German artillery. Should be the other way around. Should be Soviet spamming artillery. Let's just send the trucks to the station. We can sit doing nothing. Sort of root out whoever's still hiding it here, causing trouble for us. These guys all need like fresh ammo and stuff. We'll just have to use the crew from the tanks, there's no other way. Oh. There you go. What are we getting? More assault vehicles. Good. We'll airdrop ammunition here too, so we can just start refilling the vehicles. We only got reinforcements on the left flank. Okay. Let's kill the windmill, because it's probably a spine or so. This tank's still being blown up. I can hear the artillery though. Finding a little bit of success on the front, which is good. I found a German tank and just crushed it. Their artillery is definitely somewhere over here. Let's try and find it by listening. They want to shoot at us now. Our reinforcements in as well. They're assembling there, I think. We've got our ammo. And our supply trucks. Just get them all resupplied. Who's this last? Tell me there's someone in the house with nobody in. Okie dokie. So, now we can pretty much assault this final position in the east, and then we can swing west. Though I don't think the west needs much reinforcement, as it has the Katyusha rockets on board. What? Oh, it's just one man. It sounds like an entire battalion marching around. Send the flamethrower attack to them. Oh, nice, we found their rocket launcher. One of the most powerful weapons they have, actually. Probably out of ammo, though. Oh, wow, there's a Ferdinand. Save the flamethrower tank, so. Took out our tank without an issue. Alright. Well, the elephant died and I weren't lucky. And there it is. That German supply truck. Now we can go and burn out these foxholes with the flame tanks. The enemy's sitting right there as well. Should assault towards that direction with them now. I'll just throw in all of these guys for reserve. It's this foxhole here that's gonna see us. There's a tank there, there's a stoop. Unbelievable.
Маневр готов.
another stone gun. Is there another flying tank gun? Is that dead as well? Yeah, there's an anti-tank gun hidden in the trees. Finally destroyed that trench there. Yeah, get real. The KV-2, are you sure? I mean, it's got so much armor. Finally found some of their artillery. Good. There's an anti-tank gun hidden somewhere, killing us all. We do need some more tanks to deal with these resupply trucks that seem to be invincible. Pull the infantry back and kill the bunkers. Falling some ammo here as well, so you can get another resupply. And bring up all the resupply trucks. And whatever's just sitting behind. This mod definitely favours the person sitting there camping, because the buildings give the people in houses way too much health. KV's dead. Just send everyone over here to get resupply. We still didn't kill whoever's camping in that foxhole. But I think we wasted all the enemy's ammunition on that bunker. We magically can't kill this bunker either. But it can see us and call in artillery on us. So many anti-tank guns down there as well. There you go. Our army's primarily made up now of just assault guns. Pretty much chill out and do nothing now. It's the other flank now that needs to push forward. First we should push them off this hill, make sure we took all the bunkers and stuff like that. We do things a bit more tactically and slowly now, you know, instead of just rushing in. This is the only place we've almost reached the front line. those all better go away. Just let the snipers kill them. Yep. I wonder if we can hit it with a Katyusha rocket, so we're not wasting time. No effect whatsoever. I don't understand how we can have this much firepower, this many snipers, and just get no results. Way too much health, man. Is it calling artillery on your own bunker? Bit of ammo there, not much. What we should do is we should clean out this side of the map, make defences, and just go to the other side with all of our vehicles, because it's just going to be like a trench shooting simulator. We're just going to retake this tree line. Well, to be fair, we can just leave it. I'm going to mass over there. Is this red dot? No, it's this building. It's still our tank's dead, and we're no closer to taking out that bunker. Unbelievable. The invincible bunker. Right. Let's get on this anti-tank bin and Slip it around and shoot them. Probably have ammo now. Oh, get out. What? What on earth are these guys doing? Running? Oh man, their artillery is so annoying. Because they're just sitting in those trenches, and then if we do want to kill them, they're next to invincible anyway. It's unreal. Right. Take this bunker off them and align here. Okay, who's next? So it's our objective as well then to kill, where is he? There's a general in the German headquarters somewhere at the back of the map here. So we should strike this artillery position if it is and just go straight through the front line over here and kill him. Shouldn't worry too much about anything else. It's our turn to get in those dugouts. See, the Battle of Prokhorovka is supposed to be the biggest, one of the biggest tank engagements of the Second World War. Here we are, unable to dislodge the enemy from a trench. These guys need ammo and stuff. Can hear an engine, some jeep. Good. This is honestly holding up the entire in there. Oh, you don't like that, do you? Has this guy been the entire game? Finally retook our own hill. The northwest area is secured. There we go. They had to kill the flamethrower tank, didn't they? Oh man. We don't have another one of those. There's some flipping... There's some absolute goon sitting in this building. This bunker. The northwest is secured, yeah. But the enemy's still in the buildings. We have an entire army here to smash anyone who stands in our way. First move, she should be go there. Right, nice. What is going on over here? Nothing. There's apparently someone hiding in a hay bale there. I'm just gonna kill them. Right. Next, we're on to taking back our old positions. Сапёры ждут приказа. Давай. Стартуем на связи. Мужики, вы на связи. Стартуем на связи. Товарищ командующий. Так точно. Огонь. Выдвигаемся. Батарея в бою готова. Команда готова. Давай. Так точно. Манёвр готов. Сапёры ждут
Начальник. Команда готова. Давай. Маневр готов. Поехали.
Поехали! Поехали! Готов! Готово. Поехали!
Танкисты на связи. Поехали!
Пехота готова, товарищ командир.
Понял, товарищ командующий. Thank you. done that, Charlie. Поехали! Мужики, быстрее! Да, начальник! Приказывай! Сбегай!